Hi there. In this week, now that we've gone through parts of speech and parts of the sentence, we're going to be heading into the last two circles that we're going to go through in the magic lens, which are phrases and clauses. Now, these last two are going to take us pretty much to the end of this semester, so we're not going to do it all today, but we are going to begin our journey into phrases. So our mission is to study phrases and clauses through this next set of videos. So to get started, what is a phrase? A phrase is a part of speech that made up of some words. A phrase is not a complete idea because it is a group of words that contains no subject or predicate set, and that the phrase only acts as a single part of speech. So that's an important thing to know about a phrase, and it's an important thing that differentiates it from a clause, because a clause does have a subject and a predicate, whereas a phrase does not. A phrase does not have a subject and a verb, and a phrase acts as a single part of speech, like we'll see in these examples. Now, there are different types of phrases we're going to be studying. We're going to be, first of all, looking at appositive phrases. Then we're looking at prepositional phrases. Then we'll be looking at verbal phrases. And three particular types of verbal phrases we'll be looking at are infinitive, participial, and gerund phrases. So to begin with, an appositive phrase. An appositive phrase is what we also call an interrupting definition. Typically, an appositive defines a noun, and since it's defining a noun, it acts most often as an adjective. It's called an appositive because it is put beside what it defines. It is opposed. The idea of an appositive is we interrupt the sentence to bring you a definition. An appositive may consist of only one word, or it may consist of an entire phrase. We usually enclose appositives and appositive phrases in commas unless they are exceptionally short and clear by themselves. So, for example, Botticelli, the Renaissance painter, painted angels. The phrase, the Renaissance painter, is our appositive phrase. It is an interrupting definition to give us more information about Botticelli. Since it is giving us more information about Botticelli, the part of speech that it's acting like is an adjective, which is very common for an appositive phrase. In the next example, my friend Hamlet is a woodworking artist. You can see here that although we have an appositive phrase, Hamlet, because we're giving more information about my friend, his particular name, it's not set off by commas as we saw in this first example. That's because when an appositive phrase is extremely short, we don't need to set it off by commas. So the first example with the appositive phrase, we have commas on either side of it to offset it, to let the reader know that it's giving us more information about Botticelli. And it's really not necessary. The sentence could stand on its own. Botticelli painted angels is a complete sentence. The phrase, the Renaissance painter, in this case an appositive phrase, is acting as an adjective, getting us more information about Botticelli. In the second example, my friend Hamlet is a woodworking artist. Hamlet is not set off by commas because it's short, and it's easy to understand that Hamlet is the name of my friend. However, we always enclose appositive states and appositive years in commas. So, for example, Athens, Greece, is the site of the Parthenon. Now, there are many towns named Athens, including Athens, Texas, Athens, Georgia. So I want to give more particular information about which Athens I'm referring to. So in this case, I'm putting Greece, and Greece is acting as an appositive phrase, so it's set off in commas, and it's giving me more information about Athens. So if you ever wondered why we had to put city and state or country in commas, this is why. The state or the country that follows a city, or the country that follows the state, is giving us more information. It's acting as an appositive phrase, giving us more definition about which city, which Athens we're referring to. Not Athens, Georgia, but Athens, Greece. The same thing happens with appositive years. June 20th, 1997 is the date of departure. The reason why there is a comma before and after 1997 is that which June 20th are we referring to? There have been at least more than 10 June 20ths. In fact, there have been at least 2014 of them just in this segment of the AD calendar. So which June 20th are we referring to? Well, we're referring to the June 20th of the year 1997. 1997 is our appositive phrase, so it's in commas on both sides. So appositive phrases are probably the easiest of all the phrases. So this week you're going to take notes on the appositive phrase. You're going to